I'm Mary Ellen Geist with Detroit Public Television's Great Lakes Bureau, greatlakesnow.org. And why don't you first identify yourself?
Sure. My name is Eric Leaf, and I am the Assistant Dean for Advancement at the School of Freshwater Sciences at the University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee.
And that is where we are right now, and I'm here because of the Water Summit, which is underway, and I was able to come over here and see the amazing thing. I've always heard about this place, but I'm just learning today all the amazing things you do here. Maybe you could just give us a little history about this School of Freshwater Sciences.
Sure. So we were actually founded in 1966 as the Center for Great Lakes Studies at UWM. It was a multidisciplinary program that included biology and chemistry and geosciences and other disciplines, as well as the rest of UW system. And we moved down to this location, which is the Milwaukee Harbor, in the 70s. And so we've been right on Lake Michigan for what is that, 40 plus years now. And then in the 90s, we became the Great Lakes Water Institute, which added onto studying large lake systems like Lake Michigan and the rest of the Great Lakes. We also added human health and ecosystem health to our research areas. And then in 2009, we became the School of Freshwater Sciences, where we added degree programs for the first time, and again expanded our research mission to include water policy and economics, as well as water technology development.
There are not many places like yours, and that study the Great Lakes in particular, am I right?
No, there aren't, not like ours. I think there are researchers, for sure, very good researchers across the Great Lakes at many universities. They aren't all consolidated into one place. So what's unique about our school is that we have biologists, we have chemists, we have limnologists and oceanographers, we have economists and engineers, and so and microbiologists, and all under one roof. And so, because water is so complex, water is every discipline. You need to study every discipline to understand it and to really wrap your head around it. You know, I'm going to tell a story and it's going to be too long.
Go for it.
So you're going to have to cut it off.
Go for it.
But one of our faculty members says, studying water isn't rocket science. And what he means is rocket science is very complex with amazing equations and physics, and with all due respect to rocket scientists, if you can figure out what those forces are, you can write that physics equation to take your rocket and fire your probe up to and get it to Jupiter within however many kilometers of where you want it to land. In water, if you're studying Lake Erie or Lake Michigan, you have thousands and thousands of inputs that you will never understand all of them.
And variables that you might not even know are on their way.
You cannot
like invasive
them.
Species or whatever.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So you have a thousand, you have water temperature and physics, and you have chemistry, and you have the biological systems, and you have contaminants coming in, and evaporation, and weather systems. And so you need all of those different disciplines to start to wrap your head around it. So we organize our people around the school, around a subject matter instead of a discipline. We locate them on Lake Michigan so that they can walk out their door and study either the lake or the urban water system here in Milwaukee, and our students benefit from that.
Tell about some of the research. You are preparing students, you're teaching classes here, but you're also doing important research here that helps the Great Lakes and wildlife and many fish and all sorts of things. I mean, we just saw some fish tanks. Maybe you could just talk about some of the things that you just took me on a tour to see.
Sure. So at the School of Freshwater Sciences, we say that water is central to health, wealth, and quality of life. And so all of our research focuses around those kinds of things. But the kinds of work that we do, we study nutrient contamination on the Great Lakes. We study, not just our Great Lakes here, African Great Lakes. We've studied Yellowstone Lake, Lake Baikal, so large lake systems and urban systems. But nutrients, invasive species, fisheries, and fish behavior. We look at hypoxia, so dead zones, lack of oxygen that's caused by nutrient contamination. So all of those kinds of things. We also study human and ecosystem health, so impacts of contaminants, tracking fecal contamination and leaky infrastructure, the kinds of things that close beaches. We look at microbial communities. We also have a Center for Water Policy that looks at things like what is the value of water, what is human behavior around water, how do we make good decisions around our water policy, and then we do water technology development, especially the application of water technology to environmental questions, but also to things like fish farming. We do quite a bit in aquaculture.
How many students are here? And I would imagine students study here and sometimes they stay here and continue to do research, but do they end up going across the world to teach on campuses all over the place?
Yeah, so we are, as I said earlier, we became the School of Freshwater Sciences in 2009, so our first class of actual students was 2010, so we've not been teaching that long with our own degree programs. Our students were a graduate school only, so at this time at least, we only have master's and PhD students. We have about 65. I think we're, don't quote me on this number, I realize we're videotaping, but, or videoing it.
So we'll be generalizing here.
Yes, but I think we've pushed above 100 alumni at this point. And they're going into all walks of life. Some of them are going into industry. Water industry is huge. Environmental consulting. Some of them go into government agencies like Departments of Natural Resources and agencies like that, NOAA. Some of them go on to academic careers, and many of them go into the nonprofit world. And so there's a group of them that have stayed in Wisconsin, Northern Illinois. There's certainly a strong cluster. But we have a big contingent out in D.C. doing water policy, mm-hmm. and yeah, we don't have that many alumni, but they are starting to spread out. Someone just got a job in Oregon, another one was in Virginia, both at, I think, Departments of Natural Resources or their equivalents. So yeah, they're starting to spread out everywhere.
We went out on a very special boat, and maybe just to mention about how that boat is an integral part of studying here, but you're going for a new boat too.
Yes. So we have a fleet of boats, and our flagship is the research vessel Niske, which is a 60-year-plus, Army mm-hmm. T-boat that we converted into our research vessel. And she is the workhorse of the Great Lakes, and we get her out as much as possible. But because we are a different organization, and because studying water requires state-of-the-art equipment, we really are starting to design, and we basically have the design and fundraise for a new research vessel, which will be about twice as big. It will be a floating classroom for our students, but also an amazing research platform for our scientists and scientists around the Great Lakes.
Thank you so much for telling us about the School of Freshwater Sciences here.
Thank you,
Eric. And thank you for talking to Detroit Public Television's GreatLakesNow.org.